being a pastor. I actually wanted the education because I was really involved in drama ministry, and I wanted the plays that I did to be theologically and biblically sound. How I got from here to there, I don't know. But I wanted to be ordained because I wanted the blessing of my church. I wanted my gifts, whatever people thought they were. I wanted a formal acknowledgement that, yes, other people saw in me gifts, graces, possibilities, potential. And when people lay their hands on you and say, we see God in you, we see the gift of God in you, that's a profound responsibility. It's not just jumping up on a stage to preach or talk. It's not getting to wear a fancy robe or a stole. There is accountability at its heart. And so let us never forget that even as we affirm, I have often been the only one in a classroom, on a block, in a club, holding an office, in a church. I'm the first person of color to pastor the congregation that I serve. And I've been very upfront with them. Every time there's an issue that's on TV, the violence that happens in Chicago, I've tried to say, I'm willing to be in conversation with you about my perspective on these issues. And I think it's important that even as there's this general fatigue by people of color that we have to keep explaining and educating, we cannot back away from the conversation. We still have to engage, we still have to learn. And then we have powerful white disciples who understand that they are perhaps the best ones to talk about what it means to live in a world where there is certain privilege just because you're a white person. I have privilege myself. I'm well educated. And I'm going to be real honest with you. In my community, the fact that my skin is lighter, some people have my color from slavery times on have had certain kind of privilege, and in my community it's still a problem sometimes. I'm cognizant of that. I hold myself accountable to ensure that just because I operate in a particular socioeconomic or educational privilege, that I remember that I'm accountable to those who don't have my privilege. That I'm accountable to work for a world where that privilege doesn't hold people back. And we have to acknowledge, America, as Jim Wallace says, that racism is our original sin. And I think that until we get black and white right, we're going to have a whole lot of problem with other things. We have an opportunity at this historic moment to say that we believe that a black woman can lead this church. Adult in my church. I get all of the excitement that we have about, oh, we want to get young people, we got to get more youth, we got to have things for them to do. But I'm a witness that there are people of all ages who are still willing, ready, and able to serve. Opportunity to sit and hear from moderators and the former general ministers and president. Life experience than I. Their wisdom was a great gift to me, and I'm looking forward to becoming closer friends with each of them. We have to do that in the church, recognize that each person has value and worth. And if we can recognize that those who are older have so much to contribute to the future of the younger, then maybe we can strike the right kind of balance. Questions about what I mean about justice, and concerned that while I may say that I believe in promoting the gospel of Jesus Christ, the Great Commission, like what does that have to do with justice? That is the gospel to me. Micah 6 and 8 has been long been one of my favorite scriptures. I preach that text, it's one of those things that stays with me, and it just seems that God calls it forth a lot, and it seems to be right. In that text it says, do justice, love, mercy, walk humbly with your God. I'm a firm believer theologically and biblically sound, and that God is calling his people to a deeper form of spiritual practice and biblical literacy.
Election of the general minister and president. This item lords the name of the Reverend Teresa Hord Owens to the General Assembly for election to the office of general minister and president of the Christian Church, Disciples of Christ, for a term of 6 years beginning July 13, 2017. Mr. Moderator, I present GA 1734 for consideration by the Assembly.
Thank you. The motion before the Assembly is to elect the Reverend Teresa Hord Owens to the office of General Minister and President of the Christian Church Disciples of Christ for a term of 6 years July 13, 2017. I'd like to direct your attention to the screen for an introduction to our nominee.
The search committee is pleased to introduce the Reverend Teresa Hord Owens, nominee for the General Minister and President. Terry is the Dean of Students at the University of Chicago Divinity School. She is also pastor of First Christian Church in Downers Grove, Illinois, the first person of color to serve the predominantly white congregation. You may remember her inspiring sermon at the last General Assembly in Columbus in 2015. Her journey of faith was strongly influenced by her grandfather, the Reverend Noah Hord, a leader and shaper of young adults in Terre Haute, Indiana. After earning her bachelor's degree in government at Harvard University, Terry spent 23 years in the corporate world working in data warehousing and management consulting, all the while remaining an active lay leader. On Palm Sunday in 1996, while leading the children's choir at Light of the World Christian Church in Indianapolis, the call to ministry came in a way she could no longer ignore. She left the corporate world to pursue her divinity degree at the University of Chicago Divinity School and was ordained at Light of the World in 2003. Terry has served on the boards and committees for both general ministries and the region.
Church, this is an exciting time of exploration and renewal for disciples. We can hold fast to what is good, but also reimagine our future together. I look forward with great joy to working alongside you as partners in ministry.
Listen carefully.
According to the standing rules of the General Board, the vote for General Minister and President is taken by ballot, and the nominee must be elected by two-thirds majority of the voting members present. If you are a voting member and you have not received your ballot, please raise your badge so that the ushers can see it and give you one. Now, if you have not received one, okay. Now that we've finished with that Dr. Phil moment, the moment we all waiting for, we have the results of our vote. Receiving an overwhelming amount, way over two-thirds of the vote, the Reverend Teresa Hord Owens is elected as General Minister and President for 6 years, beginning July 13, 2017. Please join me in welcoming her.
Because you have to be on this journey with me. collaborative work together. And I promise that I will do my very best. As I said earlier today, I am a follower of Jesus Christ. I'm big D, little d disciple. I'm a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ. As one of our former moderators encouraged me yesterday to bring my whole heart to this work, and I made that commitment. I bring my whole heart, all that I am, all that God has given me, so that we together might move forward in the work that God has given us to do, that we might be God's witnesses, Christ's witnesses, all over the world, seeking justice and peace, but most of all, bringing God's love to those who don't yet know it. I want you to know that I have a life partner of almost 30 years who stands with me, Walter Owens.
More than you know. Thank you, and let the work begin.